In this screencast, I'm going to show how to use the manipulate command in Mathematica, which allows us to create interactive simulations. And so in this particular case, I'm going to start with two ordinary differential equations, and I'll show the Mathematica program that solves these differential equations. And there are other screencasts that explain how to use the differential equation solver in Mathematica. What we want to do here is say, let's change these variables, the constants in these differential equations, interactively to see how the graphical output changes so we can get a better physical understanding of a process. And so the differential equations that we're going to use in this example are as follows. The dependent variables are CA and CB, and the independent variable is time, represented as T, and it's initial value problem, so we have initial conditions at time equals zero. This is the value for CA, and this is the value for CB, and then we have two constants, K1 and K2, that we need the numerical values of. These are what we're going to change in the interactive program to observe how then CA and CB change as a function of time. Now these equations represent a physical system, and the system is a chemical reaction of A goes to B and B goes to C, where the rate of this step is K1, the concentration of A squared, and the rate of this step is K2, the concentration of B. It's not necessary to understand this to understand the Mathematica program, but for those who are interested, this is the problem where we're solving for the concentrations of A and the concentrations of B as a function of time in a batch reactor. So let's look at the Mathematica program to solve these differential equations first. So we're going to start with the differential equation, where I'm given the value of the rate constants. In order to solve it, these are now the values when we make the manipulate command that we're going to manipulate. And ordinary differential equation solver, ND solve in Mathematica. So here is the first differential equation. And here is the second differential equation. And then we have the initial conditions, the variables we want to solve for, and then the independent variable in its range, and then plot commands. And when we hit shift enter, this is the output. We're plotting CA, the curve that's decreasing with time, and then CB goes through a maximum. And so solution to ordinary differential equations explained in more detail in another screencast. What we're going to do now is replace these constants. Since we want to change them, we're going to remove them. We're going to put in the manipulate command. Has to be capitalized. And this function has to be a square bracket beginning and the end of the function. And so then the manipulate command is going to have this solution. And what we need to add is what variables we're going to manipulate. And so after the plot function, I'm going to put a comma, and I'll go to new line to make it clear. And now within curly brackets, I'm going to put the commands for how we change, what variables we want to change and to manipulate, in this case K1, and put a comma, and then likewise I'm going to have similar for K2. Now for K1, within another set of brackets, curly brackets, whenever we have a list of things we use curly brackets, K1's the variable I want to change in my manipulate command. I want it to, when I first run it, to start at a value of 0.4, and then I want to label, and I put inside quotes, so when we look at it, we know what we're changing. So rate constant 1 is the variable that is K1, but we'll label it rate constant 1 to make it clear. And the final thing we need is the range where we want to change K1. And we're going to change it from 0.1 to 1.0. That's the command, and I'm going to hit return to separate. So what I'm going to do is put the same information for K2. And we should be able ready now to run the Mathematica program. I'm going to add one more option. And I'll do this just for K2 so you can see the difference. And this command appearance. And then the right arrow. And in quotes, labeled. And we'll see that how that's different and what it does in the program. I'm going to save this. And so if I've got all the commands right, I hit shift enter, it should run, and indeed it does. And so again, I have the plot like I have before, but now what I can do is I can change the value of rate constant 1, and we can see both curves are changing. Or I can change the value of rate constant 2. And likewise, see how the functions change. So Mathematica is almost instantaneously resolving the differential equations for the new values of the rate constant and plotting them. And this gives us the ability to see physical system a lot better, understand it. Now, one thing that is missing, I mentioned this appearance is labeled, and we don't see any difference, and that's because I misspelled labeled. And so now if I spell it correctly, and again run the program, shift enter, what that label command does is shows us the value of K2. So as we change K2, it's showing us the numerical value. I could do the same thing for K1 by putting in the same command. Or I can go and look at by hitting that plus sign, gives us these options of seeing the value and giving us more information. This interactive simulation is relatively easy to create because of the options built into Mathematica using the manipulate command and just telling which variables and what range we want to manipulate them over. This is a very powerful function for being able to understand physical systems.